This is Shroud of the Avatar, release 13. It's been out, well, it's been online for a couple of days now. This is one of the first releases where the character was persisted across releases. But since I'd basically run my character into the ground and didn't have any more money and the number of hours I've had to have spent actually getting my computer and useful again, I wouldn't do that, so I guess I'll just start again. Apparently they've taken the ear customization out of this level, out of this release, because it was actually too complicated. Yeah, what would that be? Nothing obvious. Let's leave it like that. So I thought I might as well start again. All I really lose is access to my quest reward from last time, but since it was only a hat, I'm sure it'll be fine. And the lesson from all of that, of course, is your armour and weapons wear out playing this game. So don't forget to loot things, and don't forget to make money. Alright, yeah, so skill point and guild affiliation got reset, but you got to keep... you got to keep your stuff. So this looks the same as last time so far. Yes, I need a sword. No, it still says the wreckers right behind me. And the weapons rack isn't behind him. The weapons rack is there. But anyway. I think I'll pick it up. Double click and do that. There we go. Okay, oh well. Where was the training dummy at? Over there. Missed it. Abachi. To auto attack. If I've got it now, does it auto attack again? No, not until I press T. Possibly that's what I've been doing wrong all this time. Let's go back and speak to Edvard. Yep, do the switch. Okay. Gate. There it was. Some skeletons to do. Attack him then. There we go. That worked. Anything to loot? And Mr. Skeleton? Lemon gold. Take all. Heal up. What's this? Oh, I've got stillness. Oh, so I think this is one of the new things in this release, is that, you get attack bonuses for standing still. Not really very much. Oh, I can't go around there. Can I go there? There we go. So, I've hit T. Will that mean I ought to attack him? I don't think it does. Another one bites the dust. I've got a bunch of rusty swords. I've got some maps. I've got a steampunk top hat. I've got a shield. £89 of £90. Alright. That was all the skeletons. Luna Rift of Braemar. Thank you, Mr. Edward. I wonder, while we're here, is there anything else I can kill? Looked around this map before, because in the release where it was new, there was all sorts of nasty things on it, as I recall. I presume going into the flames hurts. Yes. Look, I'm on fire. He's on fire! Swimming in, though. Yep, missed the stairs. Let's go up it. These ones. Tree. Well, okay. I've had enough of looking around this scene. Let's get back to Braemar. Portal in the distance. Let's do a screenshot. Hey, screenshot saved. I'll try that again with that mouse pointer anyway. There we go. Dad like. And Vard wandering around. Waterfall. That's quite pretty. Hey, I'm screenshotting like a madman. I should point out I did have the Steam overlay disabled because it used to cause a lot of problems. So this whole screenshotting with the Steam overlay thing is quite new to me, really. I don't think there's been any performance optimization work in this release, so expect these sort of things to be slow still. So what I'm going to do is have a look around, see if there's some easy quest to accept. I never really worked out how they worked last time. Some people with PvP flags there. Go and see a merchant. Innkeeper. Yes, same as last time. I took notes of this in my journal. Some story justification for only really having wolves. There we go. Check the journal. Skills trainer, I'm assuming that's a beggar. There's a skill trainer. I'm assuming I've not got any skill points to spend. Oh, speaking to the beggar. Beggar's not got any dialogue. Alright. Yeah, no skill points. Cost of 50. Okay. Now just carry on. That's the way into town. So let's head in. Quick look at what's been going on. What's that? Is that something I can harvest? Right. People fighting. So despite the fact there being bonuses for standing still, it doesn't look like anybody's really doing that. Yeah. Only when they're lagging are they standing still. We're gonna have a winner. Someone's running away. They're all running away. Oh. Looks like they killed each other at the same time. That is quite funny. Mutual destruction. Very good. So, it's all a bit laggy in here. Let's see if I can head out of town. Oh, there's the tour guide with his reindeer. Christmas tour guide with Christmas hat. Christmas hat is the reward for doing the grand tour for R13. So when I get around to doing that, I'll do another video. So. Just head on out of town. See if I can find something to fight. At some point I'm gonna have to learn how to sit down. It promotes healing and stuff. Alright. Out onto the Hidden Vale. See how far I can get. Nice view. Let's get on the road so we move reasonably fast. Let's enter the south railway. Let's see if there's any easy to hack at or something to harvest maybe. What I don't need at this point is the torch, so let's equip the round wooden shield. What I'm looking for is a creature by himself. That's a grey wolf. Harvest the cotton and hope the wolf doesn't attack. Yeah. Trying to eat running around. You're running around in order to not die. Seem to be working. Let's try the other one. Stand for do something. Right, let's use my skills. Animal hide. Where's the other one? Attack him. One wolf I can just about do, you see. There's another one. Does make me dizzy, just running around in circles now, Arty. Missed him. So I've killed some wolves successfully. I don't always manage that, I can tell you. Oh, the other one I killed. I'm running away for a bit. Alright, let's just see what I managed to scavenge. Oh dear. Alright, it ran off. Gained a bit of experience, perhaps. Not really gained any gold or anything. Let's just check what the right, so that's down to 84 of 90. That's alright. The durability is what we're looking at now. Leather chest armour, that's fine. Sword we've got to be careful of though. Because once the sword reaches zero durability it stops doing damage. And that this is what the symbols that I never understood what they were, they appear on the side here. To indicate your things are getting useless or pretty not much good to anybody. I wonder if there's anything we can harvest apart from that cotton. Tiny cool. Alright, let's go after that wolf. Go on, hit him. Tiny cool. Let's just have another review. So this down one. 4891. Should tell me how much 35 experience from Slain the Wolf. There you go. Oh. Attack him. So I wish there was some sort of indicator of when you're in auto attack mode. There we go. You know, he's standing there. It doesn't, because it's not instant. You're standing there waiting for something to happen. There we go. Something happened. Oh, let's harvest that. Another wolf. Stuff I can harvest. So let's have a go at it. Ah! Ah! Attack him! There we go. Try that. Alright, so I think I missed harvesting the ore. I'm not sure I got to it. Where was it? Oh, that's quite annoying. So how is that con? Did I get the ore? No. It's gone now. Because the wolf distracted me. Oh, there's two of them over there, look. Oh, somebody's aggroing the wolves. Wolf pack leader. It's a bit of a tie at the minute. And there we go, slight edge. If I stand still though, all them other wolves are going to get me. Hopefully this isn't making you too dizzy. I should point out that this particular attacking technique I learned from watching a video on Eurogamer. He's regenerating now, look. Alright, so I don't think I can take him. Let's run away. Let's regenerate some health. He regenerates at the same speed, look. Is he chasing me? Cast a rend. Got him. Fortunately, all the other balls run off. Get more 100 experience from a Wolfpack leader. Look at that. How much damage did I do to my sword though? Quite a lot. So, to repair your stuff, you can buy repair kits and things. The repair kits cost 100 and only restore about 20 durability, is that the correct? The correct terminology. So what I really want to do is see if we can do some uninterrupted mining. More walls. More walls. There's some cotton over there. Run over here and see if they're following me. There's spiders over here somewhere, look. Yeah, lots of spiders. Let's run away from the spiders. See if we can set the spiders on the walls or something, because that would be quite amusing. So I'm 35 minutes in. I think probably that'll be enough for this video. I've succeeded in not dying so far. There's not an awful lot that's changed since the last time. There are a few new areas and stuff, but we'll get to them on the grand tour. When that happens, that happens later. So that's me with a rabbit on my shoulder, signing off for now.